Hey, this is Jason Forrest. Have you noticed that when you're driving down the road and all of a sudden you don't know where you're going, you turn the radio off and then you slow down? Well, that's because you're in a place of fear, and what's happening is your amygdala is hijacking you. Well, that's also what's happening right now to our customers and our potential customers, our prospects, is they don't exactly know where they're going. And so as sales warrior, we have the ability to get them headed back in the right direction. And so I'm gonna give you a couple of tips that I like to focus on whenever my potential customers are procrastinating. Number one, I wanna make sure I'm very clear with them on why they're doing what they're doing. So I have a strategy that, let's say a customer comes to you and they're just wanting to hesitate moving forward with you. So what you wanna do is you wanna chunk up to their why. Okay, so you would ask questions like, well, besides this is happening right now, what's the reason why you'd want to move forward? Besides the coronavirus, how does our product and service really benefit you? So besides the coronavirus, how does our product and service really benefit you? How will it improve your life? What will it do for you? These are all things. So I'm chunking up to get their why. Once I chunk up to get their why, then I can chunk down to the how. And I can focus on, okay, well, you know what? Right now, let's just focus on the next step. And so, for example, let's say that that there are several decisions they have to make, right? They have to make, do they believe in you as a company? Do they believe in the timing? Do they believe in the financing? Do they believe in the product, the right product? All these things are different decisions that have to be made. So then you would chunk down and figure out, okay, what decisions have been accomplished so far? And then what are the decisions that need to be accomplished? And then you would focus on those. So let's say, for example, they believe in you as a company, but they're not sure about what product they should go forward with. So you would just say that. You say, you know what? Right now what we need to do is let's just stay focused on, do we have the right product for you or the right service for you? Let's begin there. And if it is the right product or service, I promise you we can talk about the coronavirus and make sure it's the right timing for you. So again, my technique is always to chunk up to their why and then you chunk down to their how. Now, another technique that works really well is, let's say your people are in a place of fear. So, fear is something that hijacks all of us. And so I like to ask questions to remove that fear. And so a question might be, how long do you think this is going to go on for? Based upon other economies or other situations like this, how long did it go on for them? For example, like right now in China, it only took them like 4 to 6 weeks before they opened up the Apple stores back to the public. Do you believe it's gonna take us that long to get business back thriving again? So you see, I'm questioning them. Well, when I question that fear, it weakens the hold that a person has on that fear. Another technique I like to use is, I like to ask a question that gets their conscious mind to pause for a second, which is where their amygdala is hijacking. Their amygdala is this kind of base part of their brain, one of their oldest parts of their brain that causes them to kind of react versus respond. And so I like to ask questions like, hey, suppose this coronavirus wasn't happening, then would you be moving forward? Is this what you'd want to do? Is this the right product or service for you if this wasn't happening? So again, what I'm doing is I'm tying up the conscious mind with that suppose, or if this wasn't happening, then would you be moving forward? And I'm tying up that conscious mind and I'm allowing their subconscious mind to speak to me at that moment. And that's where the truth lies. And then once their subconscious mind says, well, yeah, it would be a different situation and yes, we would move forward. Okay, well, why would you move forward? What about it would cause you to move forward? And so I'm now gonna strengthen the good part of their motivation, their why, while I weaken the negative part. See, everything I try to do when I work with customers is I just wanna remove whatever tendency they had to procrastinate. So first we have to figure out what do they want. The second thing we have to do is figure out why do they want it. The third thing we have to do is we have to chunk down to the steps, the decision-making process. And then the fourth thing is we have to question their limiting belief that would hold them back. If we focus on those four steps, then we can get our customers to stop procrastinating and start taking action.